Awesome people, today I'm Pallavi Valiaraj and today I want to really talk to you about something extremely specific and something very special, because I know for a fact that a lot of you struggle with remembering names. How many of you here struggle with remembering the names of people? Please go ahead and give me a me in the comment box at this point in time, because you know I was not always very good at names, but I started using certain techniques in order to remember names and in order to remember people, okay? Because how do you remember people? And there are times when you look at people and say, wow, this person remembers so many different names. I got to that stage. A lot of my students keep asking me, ma'am, how do you remember all our names? And that happened because I use certain techniques. And do you know what happens when somebody remembers your name? You really start liking that person so much more, because think about it. How many people actually do remember your name apart from just your very close colleagues, very close family and friends, correct? But those kind of people who probably met you once or maybe twice in life and they remember your name, they become a lot more charismatic for you, okay? And this is a very major tip I'm giving you. Generally, the kind of people who are considered very charismatic tend to remember people's names often in a conversation, okay? So think about it. Who are the people who actually call you by your name in your conversations? Aren't they the people who are your close ones, as in your family and your friends, correct? It's people you have a very deep connection with, right? And therefore, I want you to now take advantage of this particular idea, this particular pointer that I've given you, that when people take your name, there is a deep connection there that you have with that person, and that's why they remember your name. Now take this pointer and let's go right ahead and understand what are the different kind of things you can do with people in order to start remembering names, all right? So I basically want you to get to a stage that when you meet someone and they give you their name, then you should be able to remember to use their name in conversation with them. Okay, so that basically means that you have to listen to their name that much more carefully when they actually say it to you. Okay, and instantly as you start using their name more and more in conversation, they start feeling that very strong connect with you, and that really takes your charisma in their eyes to the next level, because hey, how many people do you find in life that really remember your name, correct? So if you're really bad at names, you're thinking, Pallavi, come on, this is easier said than done. How do you really do this? So a few years ago, like I said, even in the beginning, I was not very great at remembering names. People would tell me their names and I would kind of flounder in the dark sometimes and wonder, oh my God, what is this person's name? I want to be able to use the name, but I've just forgotten this person's name. So I've come up with these few techniques. I'm sure these are available and others do it as well, but I am telling you from my personal experience. So if you want to try this out, I know for a fact that you will not really forget names anymore. The first one, you must associate that name of that person that the person has just shared with you with somebody else you already know by that name. Okay, so let me give you an example. If the person says that my name is Mark, then you try and figure out, was there a person in your school or in your college, in your institute by the name of Mark, and how did that person look? Okay, and try to associate the face of that person who you knew well with this person in front of you. Okay, and that is how you make an association with another person. So I'll just maybe you have another friend you're meeting and the person's name is my name, Pallavi. Okay, you can also make an association of this name Pallavi. Maybe you know an actress, Pallavi Joshi has been an actress. Maybe you know something else related to Pallavi. Okay, maybe it's the name of a school. Where I live currently in Hyderabad, there is actually a brand of schools, they are called Pallavi. Okay, so all I'm saying is, every time you want to make an association, think of somebody you know with that name and connect that person's face to the person standing in front of you who also has the same name, and keep that happening. Keep that going in your brain for a few seconds at least. Like picture that person and this person standing next to each other and they have the same name. Or if it's a particular film, let's say Parinita, okay, it's a maybe a slightly difficult name to remember. Now my sister's name is Parinita, but when the film Parinita came out, I also had Vidya Balan, who is my classmate and a very good friend, acting in that film. That was her debut film. And you know, for a lot of people, later on, to be able to, when my sister used to share her name with them, she used to give them the reference of that particular film, which became a super duper hit. So you realize how you are going to be able to make those associations so that the next time when you meet that particular person, whoever you've associated that person with, that person's face comes up in front of you and suddenly you remember this person's name, or that movie's name comes up in front of you and suddenly you remember this person's name because there is a connection there. Okay, so this is one very, very awesome technique of association that works beautifully, okay, when it comes to remembering people's names. My second technique for you is about listening. Really, really listening, and listening actively, which means not just listening with your ears, listening with your eyes, looking at the person, listening with your brain, trying to process whatever the information, starting with the person's name that the person has shared with you, listening with your heart so that you can really connect with the person, listening with your mouth zipped so that you can, you know, understand what the person is saying, and listening to understand. Okay, don't think about what you're going to say next to the person, okay, or don't think about other things when you are being introduced to a person. Being interested in what they are saying, whether it is about their name, their profession, their designation, what they do in life, being interested about that person, listening actively, is a great way to actually start remembering people's names. Okay, so when a person says, hi, my name is Sonia, or my name is Sharad, or my name is Bimal, listen to that information, and then that information can, you know, you, when you stay with that information, when you're not doing anything else, when you're not you know, distracted by other things around you, and when you're looking at the person and taking in all that information through so many different faculties, you are listening. That's when it makes a connection in your brain and you can remember it. Okay, my technique number three for you is very, very simple. Please, as soon as possible, try and use that person's name in the conversation that you're having with the person. So if the person says, hi, my name is Vinod, then you please turn around and say, hey, nice to meet you, Vinod. So Vinod, can you tell me a little bit more about what do you do? What's your profession like? Where do you live? Vinod, are you new to this place? Can you see, just in conversation, in those few sentences, and as the conversation keeps progressing, use that person's name often so that you do not forget that person's name, okay? And it all starts, of course, with listening and with really being interested in knowing the person, getting to know the person, and making that strong, deep connection, okay? Fourth technique that I have for you is repeating that person's name in your brain, not out loud, okay? So when somebody says, hi, my name is Mark, then you are going to repeat that name in your brain, not saying it out loud. You're going to say, okay, this person's name is Mark, 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 Mark. And maybe just keep looking at that person, but in your brain. Now, I can't do it in my brain, otherwise you won't be able to hear what I'm doing, right? So in your brain, this activity should be going on. This person's name is Mark, 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 and Mark you know, I've met Mark today, and I would like to have a conversation with Mark, and I would like him and me to go delve deeper in conversation. Just in your brain, for a few seconds, maybe 10 seconds, do this activity of repeating the person's name, maybe with even with sentences, or just repeating the person's name as Mark, 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 or Pallavi, Pallavi, Pallavi. Okay, your brain will be able to register that when you're looking at this person, this person's name is Mark, and that's how this technique can really, really help you. So if these techniques have have been very, very useful for you or have been have added value to you, to your life, then please share with me in the comment box what has been your biggest value addition, which is a technique that you are going to start using, because I really want you to start using these techniques. You will see it'll be much easier for you to remember names, and I guarantee you people will be drawn to you because of this one value, that this virtue that you have, that you remember people's names because you're interested in getting to know them. You become a lot more charismatic for people. So please use people's names often, because it's very rare to find people these days who even remember your name. They don't even use people's names in conversations. If you watch some of the older films, you will see that people used to use names, each other's names, a lot more in conversations. Today we hardly use names in conversations, and that is the reason you are going to stand out, because you have now started using these techniques. After you start using these techniques and you remember people's name, therefore you will start using them more and more in conversations. And remember what I said right at the beginning, when you use people's names in conversations, they feel a deep connect with you. They feel like you're interested in them, and then they become interested in you, and you become a super charismatic person for them. Do let me know in the comment box which technique you are going to start using, or are you going to start using all four? Also, let me know what has been your biggest takeaway. Do share in the comment box if this video has added a lot of value to your life. And yes, go ahead, please subscribe to my YouTube channel. It's very simply Pallavi Valia Raj. Click on that bell icon so that every time I post a new video, you will receive that new video. You will receive that notification. And I'm going to come back with lots and lots of other videos that I'm going to keep regularly making for you every single week. I love you guys so much. Thank you so much. Let me hear from you. And yes, I'm out of here. Ciao, ciao, ciao. I'm Pallavi Valia Raj, your charismatic communication coach, wishing you the very best in remembering people's names, because that's what matters to people. See you soon.